the most amazing Rima Kakti, ladies and gentlemen. And of course, the versatile Mr. Farhan Akhtar. Welcome, welcome. Yes. So, as I said, you know, welcome to the grand opening of this iconic place. You know, it is only fair. You know, we always talk about our culture. We take pride. Rima Kakti, Zordar Thalia, Mr. Farhan Akhtar. Sanjay sir, please, kindly do the honors. Ajay sir, we'll start with you. You know, first of all our friends from the media, they are here. We have these superstars here at this grand launch. So what do you have to say to all the people who've come to attend this grand event here?
Afternoon, everyone. Nothing excites me more than seeing a cinema full, although it's not completely full just now. And an opening of a new property, this iconic property. First of all, thank you everyone for taking the time out. Sanjay ji, thank you for your support. Aapne property di aur tabhi hum usko bana paaye. Single screen iconic cinema tha usko. Humne three screens bana diya. Shuru se aadat hai multiplex banane ki. To old habits die hard. But bahut hi iconic property hai aur really really proud to be associated. So thank you very much. Thanks Zoya for being here, Rima, Farhan, because you guys have made the opening special. And you know, this cinema is I thought because of its location and everything, it's in Bombay, Juhu. I wanted this to be a tribute to the Hindi film industry. It's going to be showing a lot of festivals, retrospective festivals, and I'm so happy that you guys have agreed to show your fabulous bouquet of films. And it's going to start on the 7th, and I'm really excited about it. It's going to show new movies as well, right. But at the same time, I think that's what I've told the boys, that we'll always have festivals here, maybe two shows, one shows, one auditorium or two, so that it you know, brings back people. You know, these movies are available everywhere, but yet to see them on the big screen, I think it's very exciting. And even the response that we've got for so many movies of yours, that we want to see it back on the big screen, right. Really excited about that. So that's going to be the USP of the cinema.
Thank you so much, sir, for sharing that. Mr. Gupta, over to you. You know, talking about this partnership with PVR INOX Limited and Lido, you know, coming together. This is going to be out of the world. Talk to us about that.
Hi. Hello. Good afternoon, everyone. So we are into this single screen business since 45, 50 years. And I have three theaters in Bombay. Lido was always close to our heart. And to be associated with a partner like PVR is like a feather on the cap, like nothing better than this. And what I could think or imagine, he's done beyond that. So it's a privilege to be a part of PVR family.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir. Zoya, coming to you, completing 15 years in the industry. Ladies and gentlemen, ek bar zordar taaliyan ho jaye for this wonderful, wonderful filmmaker. You know, we are here to celebrate this iconic theater. At the same time, your journey, what do you have to say?
It's very exciting. This theater was a single screen, and Farhan and me were in a school down the road. So we crossed this theater in and out every day. And to actually be here and be a filmmaker for the last 15 years, it's almost surreal. Today is also 9 years of Dil Dhadakne Do. And I want to thank Mr. Gupta and Mr. Bijli for giving us the best birthday gift, which is playing our films back on the screen. It really takes something to actually develop a space and to be able to play films that have happened, to put festival films out, and to keep the culture of cinema going. We are the capital of the film industry here, and to be able for them to enable this and to keep the youth that's coming to be able to watch older films that maybe have been before their time on the big screen is a real gift. So I want to thank the two of them.
Thank you so much for sharing that. Reema, moving on to you. You know, talking about this maverick filmmaker here and this journey that we are all set to celebrate with this amazing film festival. Your thoughts on that?
I think that Zoya has been, one of the defining voices of modern Hindi cinema. And what makes her, I think, so special to me is, you know, whatever she's doing, whatever the idea or the genre is, her take on it, yeah. You know. And she reads a lot, keeps herself informed, is constantly searching, and then uses all of that and her mind in her work, and I think that's what sets her apart.
Right. Thank you so much. Farhan, this one's for you. Please bataiye thoda sa, yahan Zoya ko celebrate kar rahe hain, unki jo puri journey hai 15 saal ki, isko celebrate kar rahe hain. In fact, 15th year hai, luck by chance ka bhi. So, ab is waqt kya lag raha hai?
Good afternoon. Pehle to main, before I answer your question, I want to quickly say a couple of thank yous. I'd like to say thank you to Ajay for really, really being a torchbearer when it comes to encouraging people to come into theatres, making it a pleasurable experience, making it a comfortable experience, something that's memorable, it's time well spent, money well spent, and you really, really, Ajay, have been doing a great job with it for years now. Hamari mulaqat hui thi during the pandemic, if you remember. We met on some island in Maldives or something somewhere, and we were talking, yaar, log aayenge wapas theater mein, sabko aadat lag gayi hai TV pe film dekhne ki, and it's so heartening to see that in what numbers people have come back to a theater, because this is something that I think Indian people culturally just enjoy. You know, coming to a movie theater, sitting with strangers, experiencing something together. And again, just Ajay, PVR, you, all of your entire team, you're doing an incredible job. Sanjay ji, aapne kaha this theater is very close to your heart. It was very close to our school. So we are very, very thankful for that. I saw Gandhi here. I saw Rikki Tikki Tavi here. You know, so some very interesting films our school brought us to see. So I have very, very fond memories of this place, and it's very nice to and very nostalgic to be back here. Now to answer your question, I'm very happy that Zoya has taken so much inspiration from her younger brother over the last. Bas yahi kehne ke liye main tha. Thank you, man. No, I completely agree with Reema that Zoya is a very distinct voice in today's landscape of filmmakers. She has her own style, she has her own way of writing, of directing, of presenting a film, which is very, very unique to her. And honestly, as a collaborator, as a producer, as her brother, and as somebody who's a flag bearer for her wherever she goes, I couldn't be happier or prouder.
Thank you so much.
I want to say that there's someone missing here without whom this journey wouldn't have started. And that's Ritesh Sidwani. He couldn't be here today, but he's really backed every crazy idea we've had and with full gusto. And I miss him here right now. And I want to thank him as Farhan and Reema, without whom I wouldn't have these movies. So thank you.
Thank you so much. Ajay sir, the next question is for you. You know, if you were to talk to us about this property, the iconic property, you know, it's like legacy of Indian cinema, you're taking it forward. Why Lido? Why did you say that I want to revamp this particular property?
I think because हर तरह के सिनेमाज अपॉर्चुनिटीज इंडिया में भी अवेलेबल है. स्टिल वी हैव 5,000 सिंगल स्क्रीन्स एंड दोज सिंगल स्क्रीन्स हैव गॉट 1,000 सीट्स ईच. सो दैट्स अ लॉट ऑफ कैपेसिटी देयर. एंड प्लस यू हैव मॉडर्न डे मॉल्स एंड शॉपिंग सेंटर्स, सब कुछ आ रहा है. तो आई एम नॉट हंग अप कि इट हैज़ टू बी अ शॉपिंग सेंटर, इट हैज़ टू बी अ मॉल, इट हैज़ टू बी. अगर लोकेशन अच्छी है, सिनेमा आइकॉनिक है और अगर अपॉर्चुनिटी मिलती है, वी गेट द अपॉर्चुनिटी एंड द डेमोग्राफिक इज देयर टू watch movies in that place and can create something different. Like in this particular cinema, we've only got 326 seats. But when I first saw the layout, the legroom seat width was very small, you know, less. It was about 1100 millimeter by 550 millimeter. Then I spoke to Sanjay ji and I said, okay, let's do 1500 millimeter and 750 millimeter width and 1500. So, and I have a, you know, swivel table and all, so that it can become slightly different to all other cinemas. There are a lot of cinemas here. Andheri mein hai, do Varsova mein hai, Arun Juhu is right here. And this doesn't have anything other than the cinema to attract people. It doesn't have, you know, food or shopping or anything like that. It's standalone. So standalone, I wanted to make it very unique. Right. And so that's what it is. So hopefully people will like it. So it's not just the content, which will be, obviously that's the main driver to get people in. But at the same time, मुझे लग रहा था कि अगर हम seats, carpets, you know, decor, art deco, bring that little nostalgia back. So, you know, perhaps people will like it. So I'm hoping people like it.
Right. I didn't mean to eavesdrop, but यहाँ पे मैं सुन रहा था, कोई बोल रहा था बड़ा comfortable है, तो अब हमको पता लग गया कैसे ये सब बहुत comfortable है. So are we like planning? Are there like plans to develop this particular property as an art and cultural hub for the entertainment industry?
Why not? But jagah nahi hai. If I had more space, there was somebody who wanted me to do something called Movieium, like bring posters and lots of things, but jagah nahi hai. We only have space for 3 screens and enough space for the foyer areas and car parking, because you know all the old cinematograph act and building bylaws and NBC code had to be followed. But other than that, through content, I can do that. Through movies like the festival that we're doing now. We played Manthan last week, not here, but somewhere else. So all these old films are coming back, and you know, people are enjoying the festivals. As Farhan said, the, you know, the habit of people to go out and watch movies on the big screen is not going to go away anywhere. Of course, we had a body blow during COVID. So kafi kuch hua, kafi disruption hui. But at the same time, I think it's like Zomato or having a kitchen at home. But at the same time, people are not that straight jacketed that they only do one thing. Ghar pe bhi dekhenge jab dekhna hoga TV shows, aur movie bhi dekhenge 8 hafte ke baad, but bahar bhi jayenge. So that's where we fit in. That if they want to go out, it must be an incredible experience. But this I can't get at home. That's what I'm. That's all we are doing.
Talking about incredible experience.
Can I just quickly add something, because I think this is very important when you're asking him about why Lido. You know, the thing is that whenever we, at least in our country, there is no concept of finding a street address or telling somebody a road name. Wo kabhi hota hi nahi. To aap hamesha landmark pakadte ho. To ye area ka landmark Lido hai. To aapko kisi ko bolna yahan par aana, ab Lido jante ho, usse do building aage right pe aap jaake turn kar lo. So Lido is a landmark. So anybody who knows about this area of Juhu knows where Lido is.
Thank you so much, sir.
In fact, please. Javed uncle, a few months back in Saregama Pa had said ki ek theater hua karta tha Lido. Main wahan se guzarta tha, fir wo director mujhe leke hum log story sunne jate the.
So you inspiration sir wahi se to nahi aa rahi thi?
Absolutely.
Hai na? Please tell us about your journey with Lido, because ye bade dil ke khas kareeb hai aapke, maine suna hai.
So this is the third life of Lido. So we've catered to 50s, 60s, 70s era. Then 80, my father purchased. We had 80s, 90s played. We shut down in 94, and now with the help of PVR, this is the third life, which is as per the new generation. Mm-hmm. So let's hope.
Thank you, sir. Thank you. So I have another question for you. You know, talking about this 15-year journey, or kaise ek ke baad ek blockbusters aapne diye. When you look back at this journey of yours, what is that one thing is waqt jo zehen mein aati hai ki wow ye hua hai ya ye hua hai?
I mean, the first thing is that I wanted to be a filmmaker and I made a movie. Yes. I think that's awesome, and today I'm still making movies and that's awesome. Mm-hmm. So I still have a job. Right. So I'm very grateful. I love what I do. I love cinema. And this industry is just it's got all my heart, this industry. So, I mean, I don't want to be anywhere else. This is my home. So I'm very happy to be here.
And when your movies are showing, we don't want to be anywhere else. We want to be here at PVR INOX. Reema, this one's for you. Please tell me, you know, you worked with her for quite some time now. What is that one thing? We often say that this picture is different. Thodi alag banai gayi hai, hatke hai. These are the words that we kind of use every now and then. What is that one thing about Zoya's storytelling or direction that actually, you know, sets it apart from everything else, everybody else's work?
Actually, I think I already told you that in what I said the last time. I think it's take, you know, right. Because, you know, 10 directors can do the same story.
Right.
But it's Zoya's take on it. I think that makes it different.
Right. You know, talking about 10 directors doing a similar kind of stuff, I believe when you, the both of you had started long time back, there was this short story that you guys were supposed to direct, right? Likh to liya tha. वो क्या हुआ वो डायरेक्ट नहीं किया कब देखने मिलेगा
I don't know when we're going to do it. It
but ended that's going to happen?
You know, we...
You never know.
When we started off, we were assistants. We met when we were assistant directors. And we thought we'll write a short story and co-direct it. What happened through that process was we understood we could write together, but we can never direct together. Ever. So that's where, that was the learning from that experience.
No, but 20 years later, that changed too, because we did co-direct an episode in Made in Heaven together.
So the next time you guys do a movie together, yehi chalayenge wo. Ki humne kaha tha, ji haan, phir se suniye Zoya ka kya kehna tha, Reema ka kya kehna tha. But I'm talking about your collaboration with Zoya. Yeah. What is that one most special film that you guys have worked on and it'll always be with you?
Yeah, the, honestly, these questions are very impossible to answer.
Koi ek.
Aapka favorite bachcha kaun sa hai? Kya keh sakta insaan? Honestly, it's tough to say. I can say that probably the most fun we had making a film was making Zindagi Na Milegi Dobara together. Because the kind of film that it was, right. I mean, you could have fun. So that was probably the most enjoyable experience, not just for me as an actor, I think for everyone. On the film. It was, but every film, I mean, be it Luck by Chance, be it Dil Dhadakne Do, and anything in the future that she'll cast me in will always be very, very good and very enjoyable.
Talking about Luck by Chance, how was it then? You know, again, journey ki baat ho rahi hai. It is only fair ki wo pehle din ko yaad kare hum ki jab wo direct kar rahi thi aapko.
Ji, mujhe matlab bahut clearly yaad nahi hai ki what was the first day of shoot. Mere khayal se, if please correct me if I'm wrong.
Chiplun. The first scene we shot was Farhan, Isha, the Nick character Sharwani, and Dimple, the Nina character, having right. breakfast together.
Correct.
That was the first scene we ever shot. My first. Shot was a mid shot on Dimple Kapadia. So she's my first actress ever.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow. Farhan, for you, you know, how was it like, of course, Zoya directing you?
No, I mean, you know, the thing is that Zoya and me have worked closely creatively since Dil Chahta Hai. She's been involved in Dil Chahta Hai, she was involved in Laksh and a lot of the other films that XL has done. So it wasn't something that I was surprised that, oh my God, this girl, she said she can direct or she knows about filmmaking. You know what I mean? Aisa tha nahi. So it felt like a very natural, organic extension from what she was doing before into directing, into writing and then into directing. So I was very comfortable on set. I knew that she knows what she's doing, she knows what she needs from the performances, scene. So I was just doing my part
right.
of playing the character.
Retrospective का जब ये idea आया था Zoya, तो क्या क्या discussion हुआ था? How did it all, you know, stem? कहाँ से कहाँ इसकी शुरुआत हुई?
I mean, my office told me this, and I got really excited that this was happening, and it was coinciding with 9 years of DDD. And I mean, there's one aspect of you says, "Am I retrospective? Am I kind of done?" But then there's another part of you that's like jumping with joy that your films are going to be on the big screen again. So it's very exciting, and I'm really grateful for this.
Right. Ajay sir, what was the idea behind all this, and why Zoya Akhtar?
Nee, aap inka agar aap body of work dekhen, Excel. I mean, you're right. Ritesh is being missed here, right from. Dil Chahta Hai, you know, and you know Zoya's films, Farhan's films, the body work is just incredible. So it has to be done. Retrospective ko aise koi nahi kar sakte. It has to be of somebody who's done incredible work, and their body work is just amazing.
Right.
So I thought in 15 years, luck by chance, has been quite some time. So I think even though she's got many, many more years and decades of doing incredible work, I still thought that it's something to be celebrated.
Right.
And so that's right. It was an easy decision.
It was, indeed. You know, talking about the films that they've selected for this festival, ab wohi Farhan bhai wala baat ho jayegi ki kaise main apna favorite bachcha chunu yahan pe. Lekin what is that one movie that you're really excited to see on that big screen one more time?
I think the first one is always special. And there are two firsts here. One is Luck by Chance, the first film I directed. And the second one is Talash, which is the first film we wrote together. So I think our first collaboration, Farhan is an actor, was on one, and a writer was on one. So I think those are the two.
Right. Reema, for you, kaun si ek movie rahegi that you would love to watch again and again?
I'm more like in Farhan's zone, you know. How do you choose between the kids? Yeah, it's very hard.
Right.
I love all of them. You know, I do. I love all of them.
Right. Sanjay sir, what is that one thing jo abhi, you know, way forward kya hoga Lido ke liye, jo hame aage dekhne ko milega, aur kya hoga is partnership mein aage?
Yahan aapko sirf achhi picture milengi aur houseful milega. Tickets mil gayi to batana hame.
Ye kar diya aapne yahan pe baat. We have this you know, eminent journalist हमारे साथ यहाँ पे, वो मुझे बस अभी बता रहे थे एक फिल्म जो कि फ्राइडे को रिलीज हुई थी, दो दिन तक तो आराम से टिकट्स मिल गए, उसके बाद वर्ड ऑफ माउथ से वो इतनी आगे गई कि टिकट्स के लिए लाइनें लगाई थी सोहेल भाई ने, है ना?
तेजाब 28 शो पैक मारी थी
सर
ऐसे तो लिस्ट है लंबी.
Oh, there are a lot of people remember.
Jaws.
right. So that's all we have for you, ladies and gentlemen. I think.
Thank you.
वो फिल्म मुझे भी याद है, सबको याद है यहाँ पे. Thank you so much, Zoya, and congratulations on this. I remember watching my first movie in Mumbai in 2009 at a PVR. It was Luck by Chance. And I don't know कितने सारे ऐसे लोग हैं जिनको वो एक उड़ान मिली. You know, they've got that inspiration to do something in the industry, all thanks to you.
Thank you.
Zoya Akhtar, ladies and gentlemen.
Thank you, guys.
We'll have a quick photo op, and for that, I'd like to invite Ms. Niharika Bijli and Mr. Aryan Gupta, ladies and gentlemen.